alaikum everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are bored with a spicy masaledar version of chicken curry, I have come to you with a great option of white chicken korma with subtle flavors but an amazing taste. This is my mom's recipe and my husband's favorite too, which I personally relished right from my childhood. So let's get started.
Let us check out the ingredients and get started with the process. The ingredients required for this recipe are, this is around 700 grams of curry cut pieces of chicken with bones, and this is properly washed and drained. This is 1.5 medium sized onion that is thinly sliced, 1.5 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. This is 5 to 6 green chilies which is crushed. This we will be using to form a paste, and it has around 1 tablespoon of grated coconut and 5 to 6 cashew nuts soaked in water. These are your dry spices, which include cinnamon sticks, few peppercorns, 1/2 teaspoon cumin seeds, 2 cloves and 3 cardamom pods. This is 1.5 tablespoon of curry masala, and this is a homemade spice which includes cumin seeds and peppercorn in equal proportions along with poppy seeds. This is around 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, and we have 1 cup of yogurt, salt to taste and oil. So now we shall marinate the chicken first. So for that I am just going to add all these ingredients in the chicken. One cup of yogurt. Use 1/2 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste now for marination, and 1 tablespoon we'll be preserving it for later use. This is again 5 to 6 green chilies that I have crushed it. You can adjust your spice level. And this is 1.5 tablespoon of curry masala. And lime juice. This is 1 tablespoon of lime juice. Mix it well, and you have to marinate this in the refrigerator for at least 45 minutes, and then we will going on with the further process. While the chicken is marinating, we can get this paste ready. So I'm adding the grated coconut and soaked cashew nuts with little amount of water and make it into a fine paste. The paste is ready. Now in a kadai I have taken around 4 to 5 tablespoon of cooking oil, and I am adding 1 spoon of ghee for extra richness and taste. This is optional. The oil is nice and hot. I'm adding all the dry spices now. Just give it a toss. And now we can add the sliced onion. Become translucent. In this stage we are adding 1 full tablespoon of ginger garlic paste that we had preserved earlier, and fry this till the wrong smell goes. The chicken has now been marinating for around 45 minutes in the refrigerator. I forgot to mention salt, so please do add the salt while marination. And now we will add this chicken inside our onion mixture. So I am now adding the chicken mixture inside the onions. Drop it with all the marinade it a good stir. And let this fry with the onions. Till all the juices of the chicken gets evaporated. So this might take around 15 to 20 minutes because we are going to cook the chicken fully. Once in a while, in between, just give it a stir and check on the chicken whether it is cooked. We will cook it fully before we put the coconut cashew mixture. Till then, just close it with the lid and cook it for some more time. So our chicken has been cooking for around 20 minutes and you can see the oil has all come out and the juices of the chicken have also been soaking. The aroma is literally mouth-watering. Now at this stage, I'm going to add the coconut and cashew paste that we had already prepared and kept. After adding the coconut, you should not cook it for long. So just till the coconut mixture gets cooked, give it a light stir and wait for a few minutes. Nice, so our chicken has fully cooked. It has been boiling for just 4 or 5 minutes after adding the coconut mixture. And the gravy is now nicely thick and has come into a korma consistency. You can just add a handful of coriander leaves for garnishing and switch off the flame.
So guys, our chicken white korma is all ready to be served. I have garnished it with some fried chilies and julienne of ginger and also some slices of lemon. You can pair it up with either naan or tandoori roti, and even ghee rice would be one of the best combinations with chicken white korma. So do give it a try and share it with your family. And if you like my channel and my dish, please do subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe and also press the bell button. You will get more notifications on my further videos. Until next time, it's bye from Rizwana Rasoi. Thank you for watching.